about your neck pain.
Yeah, so just about Monday through Friday, I'm lifting at the gym, and I can always tell every time I'm finished with a lift that I have neck pain, lower back pain, and even upper back pain as well.
Is it a certain kind of lift? Is it like leg day more than arm day, or do you have a certain day that provokes it more?
Honestly, it's mostly days, especially back day as well, where I feel most of the back pain afterwards. And my techniques are all good. I just think that even after I'm done lifting and I'm rolling out my back and I'm doing my stretches, something's just not right. I actually crack my back myself, so I don't know if that's good for you or not, but that's how I get my relief, is I crack my own back. But it seems like within 10 minutes it's back to the same thing again, so.
Okay, so how often do you do that every day?
Yeah, I crack my back every day.
Okay, all right, once a day, 10 times a day?
I'd say at least 5 times a day.
All right, so let's do this. Let's start off, lay on your stomach with your face down onto the paper, and let's
Okay.
see what your spine says.
Okay.
Okay, Haley, so I'm going to start here examining your cervical
Okay.
spine and your cranium. And so we're going to start by checking out the occipital fibers here. These are fibers from the trapezius muscle that cross over the top of the cervical spine and over the bottom of the skull here. The bottom bone of the skull is called the occiput. So they're called occipital fibers. And I found one here. Is
Holy
that tender?
crap, yes.
Okay. And then let's check this right side too. Is that one tender?
Not as bad.
Not as bad. Didn't feel like it. Okay, we'll come over to this. So a little bit of predominance on the right side there. How's that feel
No,
right
my
there?
jaw's just under, yeah.
Okay. Right or left, which one?
Left.
Right or left? Or same.
Same.
Okay. All right, so now we come down to the trap fibers here, and so a little bit up there. Let's go back to that one. The trap fibers are actually the muscle fibers from the belly. Trapezius muscle, the upper trapezius muscle. Not too bad, but you have a little bit, is that tendon right
Yeah,
there? That's the top of the levator scapula, and more on the left than the right?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, now we'll just check the cervical spine here. Okay, not bad. Is that tendon right there?
No, it's not
Okay,
terrible.
good.
Nope.
Alright, so now I'm going to check the thoracic spine. We're just going to come down and test each vertebra.
Okay.
Alright, so things are cracking already. Was that tender?
Yes, holy crap, yeah.
Alright, so we've got one, two, three on the left. And then here, how's this? Not as
Not
bad?
as bad, nope.
Okay, five. It's mild. And the transition segments here seem like they're easy to crack. And not bad. So we'll probably get some motion in here. It probably won't take much. Yep, so they're already moving. And then let's see what's happening down here.
Okay.
Okay, so lift this right leg up
Okay.
in the okay, down. That's good.
Okay.
Now left. Down. Right. Okay, down. So a little bit of right lumbar dysfunction there. Any pain when I push here?
Yeah.
Pain here?
Yeah.
Left or right? Which one more?
That's right.
On the right more?
Yep.
Okay, right side. Just let this relax. I'm going to check the glute fibers here. We're just going to come across their tenderness.
Yeah.
Okay, not too bad. And the hips are okay. So as muscle, is this tender here?
No.
That's not tender right there?
No.
Go there.
Nope.
It's okay. Okay, now the hamstrings coming down here. A little bit. Wow, you are strong. How much do you deadlift?
I haven't done that in a while, but I definitely look like.
Because your back has been bothering you haven't done it? All right, coming down here. You are an athlete, ma'am. You're a solid
I
piece of
try.
muscle. So I'm gonna lift you right leg up
Okay.
and just let that relax.
Okay.
Down. Let it go. And then I'm gonna lift the left leg up
Okay.
here. Okay. Down.
Okay.
Okay, now just relax there. Okay, and so that evened it out. perfectly, even Steven here.
Okay.
Here, we're gonna start off in the SI joint. There's huge amounts of proprioceptive or nerve fibers that control body position, posture sense, and relay that information to the brain. So if we can stimulate those nerves while you're in this position, then we're creating more memory to help them remember this blocked position. And so this blocked position also helps ligaments relax and kind of helps things fall back into place. Overall, decreasing tension, and because it's decreasing tension, it'll give us a better adjustment. Spine here.
Okay.
Just keep breathing in through your nose, out through your mouth. And just sink in. Okay, so let me come back to here and push here. Do you still have pain here?
No.
Here?
No.
Okay, so this is the same place that I pushed and it hurt earlier. And so that tells me immediately that we've taken some tension out of your spine, okay? And so let's practice once. Let me show you what it feels like.
Okay.
And like what you're going to do is breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth. And I'm going to follow your breath down like this. At the end of your breath, we're just going to kind of give a push like that, okay?
Okay.
Do you crack this part of your spine?
Yes, I do.
Okay, good. It feels that way.
Yeah.
This is actually a tough part of your spine to crack on your own. All right, so we're going to do this one here in the middle. We're going to come up a little bit higher, too. So take another deep breath in and out. And let your shoulders relax. Sink in, loosey goosey. Good. One more time, deep breath in. And out. Okay, so I'm going to adjust the very bottom of your neck here. And so just like kind of get loosey goosey here, and I'm going to bring your head over to the side, but just try to let it go and let me do all the moving, okay? Let it go. So when you self-adjust, does it feel like that?
No, it does not at all.
Good. SI joint, now lumbar, a little bit further down. Good. Way in your back. So we're going to start at the top of the cervical spine. C1 feels a little bit iffy on the right. How's that?
Yeah, it's tender.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So we've got some tenderness there. And I'm also finding just a tad bit of edema here.
Yeah.
Okay. Muscle tension on this side. We actually have increased muscle tone on the left side. But this is the SCM coming down here, attaching to your sternum. So that's inconsequential for now. But we'll come to that.
Okay.
And then again, is it more tender on the right side here than the right or left?
Right.
So what I'm going to do is bring your head over to the side like this.
Okay.
And then we're just going to push in like that.
Okay.
Okay. So let's do the left side first. Very gentle, so just breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth. Go do that again, same thing. And we're just kind of like coming to here like this.
Oh my gosh. Wow, yeah.
And what I'm gonna do is just kind of same thing, bring it over to the side like this, and then push right from there, okay?
Okay.
Okay, very gentle, just soft breath in through your nose. Just let your head go. Just kind of sink in. That's good. One more at the very top.
It tends to be my left more than my right.
While you're lifting as well?
Yeah, I can feel it after though, too.
Okay, is the pain on the top here or on the bottom?
I'd say a little bit of both.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is there any pain here when I do that?
No.
Okay, so your left ankle talus needs to be adjusted. So we're just going to pull this like this. I'm going to give it a little pull, okay?
Okay.
All right, so nice and gentle here, just kind of like sink in. Very good. That was awesome. Both knees equally?
Equally, yep.
Let me see here. Whew. So I'm going to give this a little pull here now, Haley. That's good. Alright, lean forward. Bring your chin to your chest. There you go. And then lean forward a little bit. I'm going to reach around the front here. We're just going to kind of bring this up and give this a pull like that, okay?
Okay.
All right, loosey-goosey, let your shoulders relax. One more. Okay, let this relax here.
Okay.
Good, let your shoulder relax. You ever have any jaw pain?
No, not that I know of.
Do you ever have any headaches?
Yeah, I actually have migraines. Extremely bad migraines.
How often do you have them?
I get them at least once a week.
Open your jaw slowly. Keep going all the way open. Close. Okay, push your jaw out to the right against my hand. Push your jaw out to the left against my hand. Push your jaw to the right against my hand. Okay. So I'm going to adjust your jaw.
Okay.
What I'm going to do is open your mouth slightly, and I'm going to kind of bring it down like this, push in that direction, okay?
Okay.
Did you feel that?
Yeah. Oh my gosh. What was that? Oh
that
my
was your
God.
Temporal
oh
mandibular joint, otherwise known as your TMJ.
Oh my God.
Okay, how do you feel?
I feel great. I came here in a lot of back pain and neck pain, and after being adjusted, everything just feels more lighter and easy to move and not as uncomfortable as it was.
Okay, how's your tailbone feel? Like, reach, but is it tender still when you touch it?
No, it's not tender at all.
Okay, and then like bring your chin to your chest, then look up at the ceiling.
Oh wow.
Any pain there or anything?
No, not at all.
Okay, let's just turn to the window here. And then, like, let's see the range of motion this way. Go back.
Okay.
Good. Any pain there?
No.
Okay. Touch your toes. Okay. Any pain there?
No.
Now come back up. Any pain coming back up?
No, not at all.
Okay. Face me this way. Okay. Do you have anything else to report? Any other feelings or sensations?
Yeah. Actually, so I came in here with a migraine. And the moment that my neck started being adjusted, it was almost like a weight was kind of lifted off my migraines. So.
That's fantastic.